Ma'am Agawa, thank you.
Good morning, Mr. President, Your Honors. My name is Fema Ana Rosa Gunsi Mangaramas. At the same time, I am the General Manager for Monticello Eternal Garden. Yes, so we're another group po. So I'll just make this short just to summarize everything. Isa has been sharing, lahat po yun, we share the same objective. Kami naman, we're another group in Jensen, Purpose. It's also an NGO where people united to rescue pets that are abused, wasted, and sick. So our approach is holistic naman. Because we see rescuing is it's a band-aid solution to everything that we do. We keep on rescuing dogs. It will not really answer the problem. The fact that we have RA 8485, it has already been amended with RA 10631. A while back, I heard about regulating the pet shops. It is there in Section 2 even that pet shops should get a BAI. They should be registered under BAI before they can open a shop. And this is something that we try to inculcate with these pet shops also. Because last time, 2 weeks ago, we rescued these two breeded dogs in Uhao. They are emaciated. And when we try to talk to the owner, we regret to say that the owner is ignorant about dog handling. See? So this is something, we have all the ordinances on Anti-Rabies Act, yes. But we have RA 8485, 2008 pa po ito. And I think this answers everything. If we just put a teeth on the law and really impose it. It is not just the rescuers group or the non-profit organizations who will do it. It is a community thing that everybody should take their part in doing so. And I think, and it is, I am humbled to be invited in this session to be the voice for the voiceless. The group of Heart for Paws is one. We are also a non-profit organization, which is Purpose. We started in 2019, and there are still a lot of individuals doing this. As a matter of fact, although I was listening a while back, that you only have one, you should only have one dog for a 100 square meter lot. To be honest, I have 60 dogs in my house, and these are all stray dogs. How do we fund it? Of course, we do the same thing as Heart Purpose do it. If we don't have the fund, we just have to take out from our pockets. It's good na manager po ako sa may konting pera, no? But other than that, sabi ko nga, it cannot just end there. We have to do more. In Section 10, it's stated there, do we have an animal welfare desk? Yes, we do have an animal welfare desk. DILG has an animal welfare desk. Police stations have animal welfare desk. BAI, more. But the thing is, when we try to coordinate with these organizations, like for a while, I cannot just go on because I do the operations during my spare time. Pumupunta po kami mag-rescue. I try to coordinate with BAI. BAI will just say, okay, go ahead. You have my blessing. But when I try to call back, what will I do? Nobody answers the phone. We work together with City Vet because we partner with them, especially with crucial rescues. But the thing, sabi nga ni ma'am kanina, kulang talaga po ng tao. And with us, even as private individuals, we can help. We can do it. Kahit wala pong bayad yun. We can. I'm a private, nagtatrabaho ako as a private individual, but I still find time to do this because that's the heart. We need to really speak for the voiceless. So for this, really, I'm really, really grateful for this opportunity to be given. Already doing the plan to put up a pet cemetery, so that will be first in Jensen, if ever. And we are also planning to put up a pet cremation. So because there's a lot of clamors or askings in the social media if there's a particular place where they can really bury their pets. So that's one thing that we're probably looking at 2022.